Hello friends, my name is Siddharth Sinha and this video is on IBPS PO RRB 2016 exam, in which I am going to tell you how to boost marks in maths. Okay, so now what is happening? Lots of students are complaining or used to say that I am not able to score good marks in maths due to a number of reasons. One, someone is not knowing the table, not interested. Lots of students are saying that I am not interested in solving maths. So there are lots of reasons. Time consuming. Forgetting how to hit the question. Forgotten trick. New type of question, so there are lots of reasons why the student is not able to score marks in maths. One is they are not knowing the table, another reason is that they are not interested, third is that it's time consuming, of course it is a little bit time consuming something known as time is involved much here. Fourth thing is they forgetting to hit the question, forgetting how to hit the question. Okay, what's the methodology, what's the way of hitting the question, forgetting the trick. Sometimes they used to forget the trick due to pressure. It happens due to pressure. New type of question, some used to say that something new type of question has come. I am knowing everything, but due to pressure, but due to time pressure, not able to solve question. Okay, this is another reason. They are saying that I am knowing the question, I am knowing the methodology how to solve, but due to time pressure, I am not able to solve the question. Okay, so there are hundreds of reasons for which a student is not able to score the marks. Now I am going to tell you the methodology by the help of which you could boost your marks. Okay, please follow it strictly. Someone say, sorry, so now step 1, or you could say step 1, yeah, you could write it step 1. So there, I am telling the ways, so you could make point 1 rather than step 1, make it the point 1. In point 1, first thing is that read questions very carefully. Read questions very carefully. Why? I am going to tell you the reason. Let us suppose 8.234 is multiplied by 8.29. What happens sometimes in hurriness, what people used to do? They sometimes used to write 8236 multiplied by 8.29. So here it comes 6, so your figure will change. Any single digit change will cause the answer to vary. So what I request you to read the question very very carefully. This is the first thing, don't lose the marks. It will help you not to lose marks. Okay, second thing. When you are hitting the question, when you know, yes, my answer has arrived 8.339. Let us suppose this is your answer. There are 5 options given to you. A is 8.356, B is 9.2376, C is 8.239, D is 9.234, E is 101. So this is the answer basically. What people used to do, in Harines, student is supposed to mark C, but unfortunately in Harines, or they have not seen the answer correctly, they mark instead of C, they mark as B, and you will get a lot of negative number. So this is known as a clerical error. Okay, clerical error. You have done all the things, you have done everything, now you have arrived your answer, and instead of marking C, you are marking B. Okay, as your answer. This is the second thing that people used to commit a mistake. Okay, these two things you could avoid. First is read questions very carefully. Second thing is, if you arrived your answer, mark very carefully your answer. Mark answer very carefully. Okay, this is the thing. If you are doing this, you're not going to lose your marks. Now, question number 3. Solve only those questions which you are knowing. Solve only those questions which you are knowing. Okay, don't try to hit this and that question. First thing, in that thing also, there are two conditions. Number A, you could solve, but it's time consuming. Let us suppose if you are knowing the methodology, but it's time consuming, leave it. Able to solve, then solve it. Solve it in 1/2, that is 1.5 minutes. Okay. That means 1 minute 30 seconds. Make it 1 minute 30 seconds. If you are able to solve that question this amount of time, you could solve it. No problem. But if it's time consuming, say it is going to consume 3 minutes. Let us suppose it is going to consume 3 minutes. So it's a time consuming. It is better to leave. If you are able to say yes, I could make a solve this question in 1 hour, 1 minute 30 seconds, you could go for it. So these are things, these are facts that you should know. Okay, because these are the things which will help you in increasing your performance, increasing your marks, it will help you in boosting your performance simply. Now, fourth thing is that in maths, table is necessary. People don't take it as people take it as lightly. And they have to suffer. There are lots of students who are not knowing that table from 12 to 19 or 12 to 20. Okay, there are lots of students who are not knowing table from 12 to 20 and 21 to 30 mostly. I would like to say 85% of students don't know the table from 21 to 30. And this figure, if you take it, more than 60% of students don't know correctly from 12 to 20. If you tell them, tell the 17 multiplied by 3, what will be the answer? They used to think like, so start solving like this. This is not the way. This is absolutely not the way. You should know the table from 1 to 30. 1 to 30 you should know. It's a highly recommended. I'm using the word highly recommended. If you're not using this thing, you are putting yourself in a danger zone. Okay? You are putting yourself in a danger zone. So try to focus on it. Try to memorize the table as much as you can, up to 30 at least. I am using the word at least. Say if someone asks 25 multiplied by 10, in one moment you could tell them 175 is the answer. Okay, let us suppose 22 multiplied by 3 someone has asked. So, if you 6 should be your answer, in your mouth it should be your answer. Let us suppose 23 multiplied by 5 someone has asked. It should be 115 at your mouth. So, at a fraction you could say. So, this is the thing that you should know. Okay? So, don't take tables lightly. From taking it lightly, you are making a blunder. You have to suffer for it. Okay? So, try to memorize it. It's not a very difficult task. In one day, one table, you could make it. One day, one table. Forward, you will grab your marks. Now, so after table, you should know the basic formula. You should know the basic formula. Always don't rely on only on sort, but I am using the word only. Okay, you should know the shortcut. You should know shortcut, but relying only on shortcut is not the solution, because right now questions are coming twisted. Okay, questions are coming twisted. So you do not. You should know the methodology of solving the question. Okay, should know the methodology. And every time shortcut doesn't work, or trick, you make it a trick. Every time trick doesn't work here, and this. Because questions are coming twisted, it's not coming up as simple as you thinking. And put the formula, get the value. So you have to be. You should know the basic formula. Okay. Then try to, always don't rely on the shortcut. Okay. You should know the shortcut, but don't always rely on shortcut. 6. You must know the tricks, shortcuts or trick. That is a good thing, you must know. But relying, I am saying, always not don't rely. You must know the basic formula. Then you should know this thing, shortcut and tricks. Okay, so I will tell you one thing. So let us suppose if you are saying of some shortcut, so what should be the shortcut or what should be the thing here? Okay, I will tell you. Let us suppose you are required to, one question I am giving you. A pipe fills tank in 4 hours, B empty in 2 hours, and C pipe fills in 1 hour. So how much time will it take to fill if given all pipes? So this is the question given to you. Let us suppose 3 pipes are there. A pipe fill the tank in 4 hours, B empty the tanks in 2 hours, C fills the tank in 1 hour. How much time will it take to fill if opened all pipes? This is the question given to you. So basically you are going to do like this. This is the formula: 1 by A minus 1 by B plus 1 by C, and you are required to do, this is something known as traditional. 1 by B minus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 1. Now you will take an LCM, it will become 4, 1 minus 2 minus 4, sorry, plus 4. So it will become 3 by 4. It will become how much? 3 by 4, right? And you will reverse it in order to make it to A plus B plus C, 4 by 3. So we are having another method as well. That's known as something known as trick. So in case of trick, A, B, C, we will write it. We are knowing that 1 is filling in 4 hours, 4, 2, 1. But that is in negative because it is emptying the tank. Now let's take an LCM, okay, of 4, 2, 1. It will become 4. Okay, so we require to divide 4 by 4, here 4 by 2, here 1 by, sorry, 4 by 1. So it will become 1, it will become 2, minus 2, it will become 4. Just add it, it will become 5 minus 2, that is 3. Hence, this is known as total work done per hour. Okay, so this is 3 by LCM is your answer, that is 3 by 4. For this thing, refer to pipes and cistern video. So I discussed this question in detail over there. Okay, so this is the thing. So how easily you got your answer? This is not a trick. This is not something on a shortcut you would say. Okay, rather than going this traditional way, reversing it and all those things, it is much much easier to solve that question in trick way. But every trick is not applicable, what I meant to say. Okay, say, I will tell you one more thing. If you require to take an average, let us suppose if you are going to take an average of 492, let us suppose 476, 480. If this is the thing, let us suppose you are going to find the average for this thing. What we are going to take, going to tell you, there is one way you are going to add all the numbers, all the numbers. Another way is that consider 450 as an average and plus or minus it, like 474 minus 450, just do like that. So it will come 24 42, or even you could make it it is much more better. Don't make it 470, make the figure much closer to this number. Rather than 450, take 470. 470 as an average plus 474 minus 470, it is becoming 4. This will become plus 22. Okay, plus 6 plus plus 6 plus 10. Okay, so this is your answer and whole divided by 4. So 470 plus, this is 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 10, 20, 20 plus 22, it is 42 by 4. Okay, divided by 21 by 2, that means 10.5480.5. This is your answer. So I hope you get your answer in a very faster way of, in a very fast or in a very small amount of time. But this will take, this will consume your time. This is known as something called a traditional way. This is something on a shortcut, so or trick. So I hope you are getting the method, or you are getting the way of solving the question. But this is the way you should implement it. Okay, this will help you in your conserving the time, because your time is money. Okay, these are the things, some of the things that you are knowing. Now come to the hitting of objective question answer. Let us suppose one question is given to you. 7 to the power 5 multiplied by 3, 9, 1 to the power 5. Like it, some question is given to you. Find what is this thing. 1 is given to you. Like it of something number, okay, and you have to find the answer for that. I will tell you. Okay, so ending with 7, some number is it ending with 1, some number is ending with, let us suppose, 8, and some number is ending with 9, and some number is ending with 2. Make it 6. Okay, some number is ending with 6. So now you require to find a solution for it. So what is the way of solving the question? If you are able to know the, don't start, no, like 7 to the power 1 is 7, 7 to the power 2 is 49, 7 to the power 3 is 343, 7 to the power 4 is something known as 21, 7 to the power 5, whatever the number, then it becomes 7. Don't start solving entire thing, you know, multiplying with 7, once again, the number comes multiplied by 7, so 7 to the power 5 value will come. No need. If you are getting this type of question in your examination, so rather than going this thing, just we find out a unit place. So here the unit place is 7, multiply by 1 to the power 5, at last 1, and its power is 5. Whatever the number is, number 1, and whatever the power is, so it will be always 1. So 7 at the end, number will be ending with whatever the number this thing, it will end with 7. So this is your answer. This is something known as a trick or method. Okay, so this is the way of doing the question. Let us suppose you may ask something, I mind that if 2 7 is there, right? Let us suppose if 2 7s are there, one is this B, C, A, D something, A. Let us suppose this is also 7. So there are 2 7. You are saying this thing. So we could take a risk. We could take a risk of 50 is 250%. So no problem in it. It might be plus, it might be negative. Okay, you could take a risk. It's up to you. But if this thing is not given, this thing is only given, you could take it. You could make it. But if say if another 7 is there, I will tell you not to hit. If 3 7s are there, not to hit. If 2 7s are there, you could take a risk. And I recommend you to take a risk because it might help you in getting an answer. Okay, and okay. Now, practice mock test paper. Give online mock test. It will help you, know, in understanding the thing, how to hit questions in online and how much difference is it, know, in hitting the question if you are giving question in OMR seat and this thing online. It will help you understanding question, how to hit the question. Definitely it is going to help you. So go for this thing. Okay. Analyze your performance. Where are you lagging? So this thing you should know, where are you lagging? If you are able to find this thing, of course you could make a good hit. For all those students who want to enroll in the courses of Bank PO, so you could visit the website, which is www.buybankpocourse.in, or you could call us 4 times 9 685127. Another number is 7827546946. You could send us an email as well if you want. Email is siddsinha123@gmail.com. Okay, and we are having online mode of course and pen drive mode of course. Online course will cost you ₹2,000 to ₹3,000, and pen drive it will cost ₹2,500 to ₹5,500. For more information, visit the website or you could call. Thank you.